Dean's halibut has been topped with turmeric spiced courgettes and crispy coconut langoustine, accompanied by a black beluga lentil dal, tomato and red onion kachumbar salad, carom seed puri bread, mango chutney, minted kefir yogurt, and a Goan curry sauce made with over 10 herbs and spices, including tamarind, chili, and ginger.
Dean, curry should be served traditionally, rustic style. Taking it and turning it into fine dining is always a risk. And I suppose the risk is, does it pay off? That, for me, is absolutely sensational. I think you have captured every flavour that I look for in a Goan curry. The fish is beautifully cooked. I love the presentation. I love the freshness of the little cucumber on the side with the shallots. There's so much to like about this dish. I absolutely love it.
That langoustine is lovely. Those panko breadcrumbs are giving sweetness to it. And, of course, that matches the sweetness that's running through your dish here perfectly.
The puri bread with the dips is an added joy to this plate of food. And I love this mango sauce you have here. It's sweet, but it's not too sweet. And if I eat that with the fish, it is fantastic. What a delight.
Definitely worth the risk. Super pleased with comments. It's always an absolute pleasure to hear such kind words come of Marcus Waring's mouth. It's just it's worldly thing to hear, you know?
So tell me, which eggs have you chosen and how are you using them?
I've done a custard with a hen's egg with a parmesan and truffle through it. And with the duck egg, I'm going to make an egg mixture, which I'm going to cook an eggy bread in.
Are you going to give us something quite modern? It's a modern take. I'm not just going to get a piece of bread that's been dunked in mixed egg, am I?
I'm going to do it with mushrooms. I've got a couple of variations of mushrooms, some fresh truffle, some set powder, a couple of little garlic chives, and I've done a Madeira reduction as well.
Curious how it's going to look on the plate, Ollie, but it sounds divine.
Brilliant.
This sounds like a luxurious brunch dish being elevated with the use of truffles and lovely mushrooms. Love eggy bread. We have a custard made of parmesan and hen's eggs. I want to be able to taste the parmesan coming through from this custard.
Simon is a sous chef at a Two Rosette restaurant in Newcastle. He excited the judges with his signature turbot dish.
Being here and in the thick of it really does give you a sort of thirst to progress. It's time to try and compete with the big lads here, I guess. Today I'm going to be doing deviled quail's eggs, a lovage and wasabi hollandaise. I'm also going to be doing some asparagus, baby carrots, different texture of beetroot. I'm going to be using ouzu, mirin, different flavours.
Do you think there's enough egg in this dish?
Yes, Chef. I think once I get the hollandaise on there with the quail's eggs, I think that'll be a nice finish to the dish and you'll be able to really see the egg.
I'm looking forward to tasting the devil breadcrumb that goes around the quail egg. You need to be very careful with the quantity of wasabi with this dish. You don't want it to be too hot. But I'm not 100% sure. He's going to need a lot of those beautiful little ingredients to make this into a dish.
Chefs, you have 25 minutes left.
25-year-old Lawrence is a junior sous chef in a Michelin-starred restaurant. He excelled in his heat with a standout mackerel dish.
I'm a perfectionist in my food. I want to be the best on the day, every day. Getting a dish perfect first time is pretty much impossible, but I'm going to give it my best shot today. So I'm doing a slow-cooked hen's egg with a white wine velouté. I've got some asparagus, girolles, pickled cockles, a little bit of bacon in there. So it's quite simple, but hopefully the egg will stand out as the main ingredient.
How long are you cooking the eggs?
45 minutes.
What temperature are you cooking the egg in?
65. I think the slow-cooked egg gives it a fantastic texture and hopefully it will shine through as the star of the dish.
It's a big risk for Lawrence to cook the egg the way he has now because he's got to wait a full 45 minutes before he will know if this egg is going to work.
The white wine velouté will lift this dish. I want it to have a beautiful texture, a little touch of acid coming from the wine. It's got to be just right. Four minutes left. Come on, let's go.
You have 30 seconds left. If it needs to be on the plate, be quick.
That's it. Stop cooking. Simon, step back from your bench.
First up is Lawrence, who is serving a slow-cooked hen's egg topped with truffle and sliced lardo, or pig's fat, asparagus, radish, crouton, pancetta, and pickled clams. Finished with a white wine velouté.
That looks beautiful, Lawrence.
Lawrence. Delicious. Absolutely delicious. The egg, it's beautiful, it's rich, it's velvety, the yolk is absolutely incredible. The lardo on top is genius. Love the acidity to your white wine velouté and the freshness and the acid running through the cockles, the pickling of them. Fantastic. That's a solid piece of cookery at the highest level.
Lawrence, the brief was to use the egg as a key element to the dish here, and you have done that. It's an absolute joy to eat this plate of food.
Finally, Matthew has cooked lamb loin and confit rib. A courgette flower filled with goat's cheese, mint, and lemon. Courgette with confit lemon. And courgette and basil puree. Served with pomme boulangère and a lamb sauce.
I've seen this presentation from you before and I love it. It's so confident.
The lamb is lovely and pink. For me, there's just a touch too much fat left on it, but it is delicious. Your sauce looks a bit strange, but you've whisked the fat through it, so it's given it this pale color, but it is very rich, actually, when you eat it. Loving it with this courgette, with a bit of the lemon confit. So a little bit of sharpness coming through. So delicious.
That may be the strongest basil flavour I've ever had in that green puree. You've got lovely, salty cheese inside that courgette flour with a finish of lemon. You've got beautiful rosemary flavour on that rib. I really, really like it.
The boulangère potato, this, for me, is perfection. The lamb stock and the thyme running through, the little sweetness of the onion, perfectly cooked. That is sensational. Lamb is well cooked. Yep, I think we could say that the fat, the rendering could be rendered down a touch more. But what is really fascinating is the lemon running with the courgette, the freshness of it and the sweetness of it that works beautifully well with the dish. It's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
For dessert, Matthew has created a chocolate hazelnut sphere filled with a chocolate sauce, with passion fruit cream and passion fruit, a chocolate crumble, toasted hazelnuts, praline powder, chocolate popping candy, and yogurt crisps.
It looks fun, it looks pretty. I can't wait to see what's inside the sphere.
That sphere is beautifully made. And it's so clever to have a little bit of salt in there, chocolate crumb, and popping candy as well. You're getting beautiful surprises.
perfectly balanced dish. I like the passion fruit cream because it brings a freshness to the plate. The hazelnut flavour, the crumble works incredibly well. It's a very accomplished dessert in its presentation and in its eating. I like it a lot.
It's just delightful. So much skill has gone into it. Getting all the textures right, the flavours, the hazelnut being the key one that I can taste with the chocolate, and then the passion fruit, a bit of sharpness in there. Lovely, lovely.
I'm buzzing, I'm so happy that they like the food.
Congratulations.
What a relief.
William, what's your menu?
Firstly, I'm cooking a grilled fillet of mackerel with crispy polenta, avocado and wasabi, horseradish chantilly, spiced carrot puree on the bottom. There's a little bit of a radish salad on there, just give it a little bit of freshness and crunch as well. And then secondly, I'll be cooking 64% chocolate crema with compressed raspberries, apple, and the chocolate soy to go with it.
And how do you feel then, getting this opportunity to cook for the critics?
Well, there's a lot of pressure, but I'm not gonna let that sort of stop me. I'm just gonna go for it.
William is doing a mackerel dish, which he's going to take off the bone and finish under the grill. I'm just hoping that there's a nice balance of the ingredients that William has brought to the table, because we have a wasabi and avocado puree and a spiced carrot puree on the same plate.
Chocolate crema is all about the consistency. He's using a lovely, rich chocolate. The consistency has to be like velvet. You don't want it to be too hard, so you have to be very careful that when you're setting it, how long you leave it in the blast chiller.
Judging MasterChef The Professionals is a bit of a roller coaster ride. Every time that door opens, you're hoping that brilliance walks in, but you're never sure.
Every time I come in and I look at the menu, I get excited. I think we're going to see some searing new talent. These people should know how to cook.
If you can just leap and get all of those flavors singing at once and make us happy, not only will you do well today, we'll never forget you.
You have 15 minutes before the first course is served. Dean, that's you.
The lemon baked cod starter from Dean. It is full of sunshine.
Chorizo, courgette, squid ink crisps, smoked tomato puree. Well, he's taking us on our summer holidays, isn't he? The key thing is that cod in the middle. If he overbakes it, it's a complete disaster, and if he doesn't, it might be marvellous.
How are we doing?
On time.
Good.
Rocking.
It's looking nice, Dean.
Just a little touch of lemon oil, finish it and we're done.
Good job, well done.
Thank you. Good afternoon. So we have lemon baked cod. It's been slightly cured and then baked in the oven. Spicy chorizo and yellow courgette ragu. Little cherry tomatoes of coriander pesto. A smoked paprika puree. And then finally, the squid ink twill.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This looks very precise. I suddenly think Dean has a sock drawer that's ordered by colour. The cod flakes away perfectly. It's been cooked to the second.
That chorizo underneath is big and spicy and punchy, and, you know, that pesto just zings. He really understands flavours and he can really cook.
This dish delivers a lot more than I was expecting. This is pretty good.
I think it's a really lovely dish. The cod is just flaking apart. Loving the little tomatoes. I hope the critics are enjoying this as much as I have.
This is a dish that packs a punch. It's great.
Is there anything I can get on the plate now?
Yeah, the beetroot could go on the plate.
you and Michelle. You have 1 minute before you got to start serving. You've only got beetroots on
right.
the plate.
Wait, what do you want to do?
Can someone help me carve these quails?
Now, herb-scented roast quail with a spiced confit leg in pastry. That sounds wonderful.
I have to be honest, quail isn't really my cup of tea, should we say?
You may be pleasantly surprised.
OK, well, I'll give it a go.
Right, guys, your time is up and the waiters are now waiting.
Yes, chef.
What? Yes, chef. 1 minute, we'll be ready.
Good.
Right, just the pasta on the plate, we're ready to go.
Yeah?
Yep.
Credit to the chefs, because it's a very elaborate creation. Very ambitious. See how it all works out.
Chefs, it's looking really good, but oh, we are late. Where's the parfait and where's the bread?
It's here, it's ready to go.
I hope it's proper homemade chia batter, because the taste will be lovely.
Can we start sending?
We can start sending, we're ready to go.
Okay.
Service, please.
Wow, what happened there?
The guys really helped out. We managed to get through it, and I'm really happy with the plate of food. I think it looked beautiful.
Yeah, it looked fantastic. It
well
looked
done.
Great.
Well
it
done.
Looked great. That parfait looked fantastic.
Well done, Michelle.
Matthew and Michelle's starter is herb-scented roasted quail with a quail pastilla, spiced confit leg wrapped in pastry. Beetroot three ways, glazed, raw, and pickled. Dill oil, and a port and chicken liver parfait, served with ciabatta.
It's exquisite to look at. The colors, the way it's laid out, fantastic.
Oh, what have we here? A message in a bottle. Cast off on your fine dining voyage with quail, port, and a trinity of beetroot. Ahoy!
Oh, fantastic.
That's fantastic.
Very nautical.
I take it all back. It's delicious. I love this bit as well, the spiced leg and pastry. It's fantastic. That's my favourite.
I particularly like the parfait. Very, very smooth. Taste is perfect for me.
The ciabatta is lovely and warm and fresh, so it has been made downstairs in the kitchen. Absolutely super. Really enjoyed that.
The humble beetroot, will never be the same for me. The different presentation of the beetroot, I thought, was really exquisite. I think the bar's been set very high for the rest of the meal.
We have this little star for parfait, wonderful and pink in the middle. Just lovely with the warm, fresh part of the bread they've made.
With a lot of detail, a lot of skill, and these guys really did put themselves under pressure. Yes, it looked tough, but it was worth it.
Two big jobs left to do is to cook the hake and cook the gnocchi as well.
There's a bit to do last minute, so bit of a push, bit of a sweat on.
Matt, you can jump on the plating with me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Michelle, you can jump on the tempura.
Yeah, do you have enough gnocchi?
Yeah, yeah.
Guys, you've got 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Are you going to start plating on time?
Yeah.
Is everything ready?
Gnocchi's about 2 minutes off. We'll start getting the rest of the garnish on the plate while we're waiting for the fish.
I just want it to be nice and crispy. Nothing worse than having a soggy bit of skin.
There's some very interesting contrasts there, isn't there? Nettle, gnocchi, tempura, mussels. Some strong flavours there.
Ollie, Alex, you've got 5 minutes.
Have you got the tempura mussels there? Do you want to go put a tempura, top piece of gnocchi?
It's going to be strong with mussels and hake, which is quite a delicate flavour.
It's got maybe less elements as a starter.
But having less elements means each one has to be absolutely perfect.
Right, chefs, it's looking good. You need to start wrapping it up now and start sending soon.
Can we send?
Yep. Service.
Well
And this is the sauce to
Take
it,
the
yeah.
sauce for that separately.
Happy?
Yeah. I think all things considered, we did really well. Got a nice plate of food out, everything was nicely cooked.
Ollie and Alex's main course is roasted hake, served with nettle gnocchi, tempura mussels, pickled mussels, charred leek, borage flowers, and a mussel and dill oil veloute.
It's very minimalist, isn't it? I'm left wondering where the rest of it is.
The hake was absolutely wonderful. It was white, it was soft, the skin was nice and crispy on the top. The sauce, really lovely.
The gnocchi is very salty.
It is salty, but it's not dense as what I normally expect gnocchi to taste of. So it is a light gnocchi. The tempura mussel is not as crisp as I was expecting.
The hake is very good. I suggest that's the best part of it all. It's beautifully.
It's definitely the star of the show.
It's simple, it's striking. There's not a lot here, but what it does have is a huge amount of flavour.
The gnocchi is so soft, it's melting away. It's a really nice light main course to follow that starter.